Selecting, locking, and disabling control points in your mask is going to make your life a lot easier and your masks more precise. Let's learn how they work.
If you haven't yet, check out our video on how to add a complex mask, linked in the description below. Now let's learn how to edit these control points. To select a control point, simply click on it once. If we want to select more points, we'll hold Shift and click once on each point. To add to our selection, we can hold Shift and drag a selection rectangle across even more points. And to create a different selection, drag a selection rectangle without holding Shift. We can also select all points by pressing Command A. To deselect points, we can hold Shift and click on any selected points. Or hold Shift and drag a selection rectangle over selected points. And to deselect all points, we can press Shift Command A. We can also display the number assigned to a control point by hovering our mouse over it. The number identifies the order in which the point was placed. In the inspector on the right, we'll see all the control point numbers listed in order. And we can adjust the positions with these X and Y controls. Next, we can lock control points to prevent accidental changes. We'll hold Control and click on a point to open this menu. Then choose Lock Point. We can also edit the shape without worrying if we accidentally adjust that locked point. On the other hand, to unlock the point, we'll hold Control, click on it, and choose Unlock Point. Last but not least, to disable control points, we'll hold Control, click on a point, and choose Disable Point. This allows us to modify the rest of the mask, and just see what the mask looks like without that control point. And to enable a disabled control point, we'll hold Control, click on it, and choose Enable Point. The mask will immediately reflect the change.
So now that you know how to select, lock, and disable your control points on your mask, they should be perfect.
Don't forget to check out Pixel Film Studios, where you can find Final Cut Pro plugins designed for beginners and professionals alike to take your projects to the next level.
And that concludes our broadcast. Till next time, Philadelphia.